Hello and welcome to our special presentation on Headlines today. We are at the Auto Expo 2014 where me and the experts of Auto Build will get you all the lowdown on bikes this year at the Auto Expo 2014. So let's dive straight into all the action. Okay, bikes are big too on Auto Expo 2014, and now it's time for the all-new Mahindra Mojo, which is standing here. And to tell us more about it, we have with us Rahul from Auto Build, who's the road test editor there. So Rahul, tell us, this looks like a beast. What kind of displacement and what kind of engine specifications does this mad bike have?
Right, the Mojo made its first appearance maybe a couple of years back. And at that time, it was just a work in progress. It was just a way to, you know, spruce up the market and things like that. Now, this is the final iteration of the Mojo, which you're going to see. Changes are going to come. Maybe it might be, you know, coming because we have given our feedbacks to the company. And Mahindra Two Wheelers is very cautious about getting this bike right. Now, as you can see, it's a fully good looking machine, you can call it that way.
It's completely loaded, you know, you can't see the engine through and through. It's like packed engine in it.
Right. Now, the Mahindra Mojo has got a 295cc liquid cooled engine. And you can see it's a dual exhaust and everything. It produces about 27, close to about 27 bhp, which is a handsome number as well. So we are expecting it to be a nice and powerful machine. As far as the kit is concerned, you have upside down forks, you have daytime running lamps, you've got a digital instrument panel, and you can see the fancy way, you know, the Mahindra has built this bike. So it is sure going to appeal to a larger audience.
Okay, it is stylish, no doubt about that. And you talked about the engine and the BHP on it. Do you think the power to weight ratio is just perfect to make it one of the quickest bikes in India?
Right now, the
one of the quickest in the 300cc category.
Right. The problem is that this is not the final iteration of the bike. We are still doing testing. The reason they revealed this bike is because they wanted to do performance testing, and with all the cladding on top, they couldn't do it right. So that's why this is how it'll look, but how it'll ride and how much power and how much weight it'll carry will be revealed later.
The British two-wheeler giant superbike maker is also here at the Auto Expo 2014. Triumph Motorcycles came out with the Daytona 7675, and the 675R is also on showcase. And to tell us more about it, we are joined by Kshitij from Auto Build, who is more of a biker himself.
So yeah, this is the Daytona 675R, and this is the top of the line super sports model by Triumph at this moment. And the difference between the R and the standard motorcycle is that the R gets Olin shock absorbers along with a rear shock also by Olin and Brembo brakes. And plus you get carbon fiber panels on the front fender as well as carbon fiber inserts on the dash. And the power and the torque figures, the more or less are the same, but the suspension setup, tuning, everything, if you take all that into account, it makes up to a difference of around 3 lakhs.
So both the Daytona 675 Standard Edition and the 675R are here in India. Does it make the 600 to that 800cc bike range exciting enough now?
Yeah, definitely. But this is the only over 600cc and under, like, this is the only, the middleweight motorcycle that we have in India as of now in the super sports category. So yes, definitely the things that, you know, it has triggered, but what goes on next, we can only speculate as of now.
If we talk a little more here, you know, in terms of looks, the 675 Standard, which is here, and the 675R doesn't have much of a difference in terms of looks, does it?
No. In terms of looks, they're almost identical. But if you notice, the dash here is finished in FRP, and that's fiber reinforced plastic. The dash over there in that bike is finished in carbon fiber. Same thing with the front fender and the rear fender here, the one on the swing arm. So this is also FRP, while that is carbon fiber. So these are a few differences. The major differences, however, again, are the brakes and the suspensions, which in the R, the brakes are by Brembo and the suspensions are by Ohlins. And
so does it give a better performance output than the standard edition?
Yes, it definitely does. Ohlins and Brembos are like one of the best people to make suspension and brakes in the business today. So if you have an Ohlins and Brembo brake fitted bike, then you know that it is track ready and you can just take it on anytime.
Okay, so let's quickly tell our viewers what's the price on the standard Daytona 675 and on the 675R.
The standard Daytona 675 is for 10,15,000 ex showroom Delhi, while the R goes for 13.5 lakhs ex showroom Delhi.
Alright, when we talk about bikes in India, DSK Hyosung made waves last year, and at the Auto Expo 2014 they've come up with a new Hyosung Aquila on the go. So Rahul is here again with us. He's the bike expert by Auto Build. So he'll tell us, what this new cruiser is all about.
Right. Siddharth, basically what has happened is they've plonked in a 250cc engine, which produces about 26 bhp, and in a cruiser format. But what they have tried to keep is the big cruiser feel to it. So it feels big. It's got lots of chrome on it. A big 14-liter fuel tank. So it can take in a lot of fuel. You can go the miles on this one without worrying at all.
Okay, if we talk about the pricing and the launch of this bike, what's the pricing like and when can consumers get it?
Right, the bike is cost about 2.5, a little over 2.5 lakhs, and I think it's good value for money because you get a lot of kit with this bike. All this chrome footboards, these are like a pseudo American brand, so you are getting that feel at a lot less money. Moreover, this is a V-twin motor. It's not a single, it's a V-twin motor, which makes all the difference during the riding. So I think it's good value for money, and the way it looks, I think it looks fantastic, and it should do a good job for racking up the sales figures at DSK Hyosung.
DSK Hyosung has really made waves in the Indian market, and they've kind of churned out numbers also, especially because of the pricing that they've done on their bikes. And more bikers are enthusiastic about bigger engine bikes. So do you think we'll see a lot of cruisers from their stable, or are we going to see a lot of super sport bikes also coming out very soon?
What they're trying to do is get another new motorcycle called the 250N. The 250N is a naked sports bike, much like the FZ. We can call it the Yamaha FZ, but it comes with a 250cc single cylinder, and that will enable them to price it right. So given the pricing right, they can do a lot with that particular motorcycle.
Alright, when we talk about bikes at the Auto Expo 2014, we can't miss Honda, of course. Honda has come up with this new concept bike, which is the CX-01. The headlamp looks much more like the Optimus Prime from the Transformers. It's got a nice LED finish to it. And what's so special about this bike is that this is a fully designed and made in India. It's made by Honda R&D India. It's designed, produced here, and on show at the Auto Expo 2014. We tried to talk to the designers at the Honda R&D India as well, and they're standing behind me, but they are not authorized to talk because Honda is trying to keep everything a hush-hush about this bike, especially because it's a cross between a street racer and a naked street bike. You can use it in the city. It's got a very nice upright position to it. The design elements are brilliant. It's got many vents in it for a good airflow as well, and plus it houses a 250cc engine right now. And what reports are suggesting that whenever this bike will finally launch in India, it will have a higher engine which will give you performance and will be the bike for your weekend ride. So this is one bike that you have to look forward to. Alright, the Cafe Racer concept is going big in India, and here we have at the Mahindra stall are the two new iterations on the Cafe Racer concept by Mahindra two-wheelers. So Rahul, what are these, this craze with the Cafe Racers among Indian bikers growing?
Yeah, the cafe racer culture has suddenly caught on in India, especially with the launch of the Royal Enfield Continental GT. Now everybody is trying to do a cafe racer. We've seen a very cheap iteration of the Hero cafe racer, and now here we have a cafe racer which is a completely custom-made machine. Now the underpinnings of this is of the Centura, so the chassis, engine, everything is belongs to the Centura. But from then on, it's been completely redesigned and built by JC Moto. Now JC Moto belongs to Joshua Crasto, who is a Bombay-based customizer, and he's very well known in the industry for meticulous finishing of his motorcycles. On this particular bike, you have upside down forks, you know, clip-on handlebars, which give it a better stance, plus a completely new body kit.
So you're saying that this is the bike that is going to come probably to the Indian markets, and what's the price, best guess price that you think it's going to have?
Now Siddharth, yesterday we were told that Mahindra two-wheelers is trying to get into the custom scene. So what they might offer is kits from the showrooms, or maybe they can take the custom orders and get them built by Joshua or anybody else. So I think that's a very lucrative market. As far as pricing goes, it all depends on the customer. Because what kind of kit do you want? Do you want the bodywork only? So that will cost something else. If you want the complete kit, like with the upside down forks and things like that, it will become a lot more expensive.
What do you think? These bikes running on Indian streets, will it look really cool?
Of course. I mean, these are bikes which you maybe ride once a week or something like that. Go out on a ride, show off to your friends, and you come back home, polish it and keep it back. So for them, this is the look to have.
Alright, it's time for a very short break on our special presentation from the Auto Expo 2014. But you don't go anywhere, because there's a lot more action coming your way on the other side.